I'm starting a new book today, which is The Linguistic Wars by Randy Allen Harris. This is a book that was recommended to me by my sister 4 years ago, back in 2017. My sister actually has a degree in linguistics. Unlike me, I just dabble in linguistics, but she actually has proper credentials, a doctorate in linguistic anthropology, a job at the university teaching graduate students in linguistics. We were talking, my sister and I, about Chomsky and some of the controversies surrounding Chomsky. I was actually at the time reading The Kingdom of Speech by Tom Wolfe, which I've reviewed on this YouTube channel before, and talking about the controversies that Tom Wolfe was writing about. And my sister mentioned this book. I think she initially mentioned it as being similar, but actually this book is about Chomsky's much earlier controversies in the 1960s and 1970s. I think Chomsky was constantly getting into fights within the field of linguistics, hence the title, The Linguistic Wars. I also talked to her briefly about this book, actually, the last time I was home for Christmas, about a year and a half ago. And I got the impression, although I didn't confirm this exactly, that she uses this as assigned reading to her graduate students. Because it sounds like she thought this did a very good job of summing up what the different theories in linguistics were and the history behind them and the evidence for each of them. My sister recommended it to me at the time, and I was at the time back in 2017, back home in the U.S. for a vacation, a visit home. So, when I get to Vietnam, it's so hard to find books. So if there are certain books that I know I'm going to want to read, I make a point of getting them before I leave. Now, this book is still in print, I believe. Actually, I don't know. But it wasn't actually at the local bookstore. But the local bookstore said they could order it for me. It cost $50, which is a lot of money for a book like this, especially a paperback book like this. But I am such a slow reader that a book like this could occupy me for a couple months, 2 or 3 months easily. I mean, we'll see how long it takes me to finish this off. But historically, I've been a real slow reader. So viewed in that way, the $50 on kind of a per day investment of how long it takes me to finish the book is actually looking pretty cheap in terms of splitting it over the number of days I'd be reading the book. So I said okay, I agreed to it. And then I remember going back to the bookstore to pick it up 2 weeks later when it had finally arrived. And it was a different guy behind the register, and he was not great at customer service. He was really upset because somebody had filed the book on the wrong way in the computer. And he was also really upset that I was paying $50 for a book, even though, it was his job to sell it to me. But he was like, ugh, $50 for a book. Well, it must be some book. And I was just like, what can you say in those situations? I'm just trying to smile politely and feeling embarrassed that he's calling me out for paying too much for a book. But yes, then I got it, and my intention, I was at the time working my way through Chomsky's Universal Grammar, a book I've just got done reviewing on this channel, but my intention 4 years ago was to finish this one off first, because I thought, okay, first, I'm going to get my head around what the theory is, and then I'm going to read about the history of the controversy about the theories. That seemed like a logical progression. Unfortunately for me, this book took me ages to finish, and partly that was because I stopped reading it and then started it again, and stopped reading it and then started it again. But also, it was because this book was really difficult for me. A real struggle to comprehend, at times above my comprehension level. I mean, I did my best with it, but this I really struggled with this book. So in the meantime, I've had this just sitting on my shelf for 4 years. In fact, I just pulled it off the shelf yesterday, and there was all this dust and stuff at the top of it, which I've mostly cleaned away now. Actually, that's a small misrepresentation. This book hasn't been completely idle collecting dust. I did loan it out to a friend and coworker. There was a young guy who started up at my company teaching English, and he had ambitions to do a year or two teaching English and then pursue his doctorate in linguistics. I thought, well, this book would be really useful for him given his academic ambitions. So I loaned it to him and I said, okay, I have this paranoia. This has nothing to do with him because I had no reason not to trust him, but in the past I've loaned books to people and never gotten them back. And so I've developed a paranoia about it. So I said to him, okay, I'm gonna loan this to you, but I do really want to read it someday, so I do really want it back. And he said, yeah. And to be fair, I did get it back. He spent a long time reading it. Longer than I expected, because I thought something like this would be right up his alley. But, I mean, to be fair, I think there's a lot to chew on in this book. I mean, we'll see what my verdict is on after I finish it. So I was a little worried at points that the book had disappeared, but he kept assuring me he was reading it, and he kept assuring me, moreover, that despite reading it slowly, he was thoroughly enjoying it, and talked about some of the interesting controversies that the book touched on. And just going to Goodreads or Amazon or just briefly looking at the reviews for this book, and there aren't a lot of reviews for this book because it's a little bit obscure, not entirely obscure, but it's not entirely mainstream. But the reviews of this book do seem to agree that it's gets a little bit into the nuts and bolts or into the weeds of some of these linguistics debates, but also that it's an entertaining look at the personality conflicts, because it was not only I'm led to believe it was not only the theory, it was also the egos that got involved, and some of the gossip behind that. At least that's my impression. Again, we'll have to compare this once I finish the book. So he gave this back to me like 3 years ago now. And both he and my sister actually would occasionally ask me how this book is coming or if I'd read it. And I said, yes, I will read it. I just want to finish Chomsky's Universal Grammar and Introduction first because I want to understand the theory. And both he and my sister said, no, you don't need that. This book in and of itself will explain everything you need to know as you read it. It kind of explains the theory as it talks about the controversy. And in fact, just flipping through this, it does seem like there are, you know, some sentence trees in here and some probably technicalities, but I think actually this book was much worse. I probably actually have done this completely backwards. I think this is the book that's written for more of a lay audience. This is the book that's written more technical. I thought I would need to read this book as a preliminary to this book, but perhaps I would have understood this book better if I had read this book first. I think this is probably going to be the easier read, hopefully. By the way, in case I didn't make it clear on my review of this book, which I, again, just did previously on this channel, this book really did my head in. After finishing this book, I thought, okay, I'm not smart enough to to comprehend this stuff. I am done with Chomsky's universal grammar. Too smart for me. I'm gonna stay in my lane, read stuff about grammar for the ESL classroom, but not try any more Chomsky grammar. So this was the book that made me realize that I am not smart enough to handle this stuff and will not be pursuing it. But before I hang up my hat completely, I do want to read this book. It's been on my shelf for so long, I'm curious. And then I think after I finish this book, no matter how I feel about this, whether it's entertaining or not, after this, my reading choices are going to be a lot less ambitious in the future, at least in terms of linguistic books. I'm going to stick more with books designed for the ESL teacher, more useful, simple, pedagogical books. But this book looks like it could be quite interesting, and I've just now just read the preface. And already in the preface, you can see the humor of the author coming through. There's a very jocular tone, a lot of jokes being made. And then interestingly enough, he talks about how he was sort of collaborating with Chomsky on this book. Chomsky and a whole bunch of names here, who I don't recognize because I'm not an expert in the field. But then the other guy, Lakoff, is apparently Chomsky's rival, and talks about how both Chomsky and Lakoff apparently were proofreading this book before publication and not very happy with the way things were portrayed, which he takes as a, what does he say? I am naturally distressed by their negative reactions, but it would have unquestionably been impossible to satisfy both. Perhaps by satisfying neither, I am closer to neutrality than either of them believe. Yeah, perhaps. I would say, well, perhaps, we'll see. Except I don't have any of the expertise necessary to judge this book. So I'm just going to be along for the ride to see what kind of a story this author tells. And also hopefully understand some of the linguistics along the way. We'll see, as I mentioned in my review of this book, I am somewhat reaching the limits of my intelligence. Not somewhat, I am outright reaching the limits of my intelligence when I get into Chomsky and linguistics. But yeah, we'll see. So my plan is to read this book and we'll see how long it takes me. A book like this, in a good time, would take me about a month. It's probably not going to be a good time because I've got a lot of other commitments and a toddler at home. So I'm going to predict maybe 2 or 3 months on a book like this, unless I get distracted. Who knows, I might get distracted. But I'm going to give a real go at concentrating on this book, finishing it off. I'll be talking about it in my weekly reading vlogs, and then I'll come back with a full review once I'm done with it. So yes, that's all I have to say for now.